family and big country side team. This year at Playdate we were due to bring our popular but very messy Mud Kitchen. As we're not running Playdate in the same format, I am here to tell you how you can make a really simple Mud Kitchen at home. Now, if you've got a nice muddy patch in your garden that you're allowed to use for Mud Kitchen, that is ideal, but don't worry if you don't, because you can always buy some mud to make your Mud Kitchen. If you are buying mud, make sure you get topsoil and not compost, because when you add water to it to make your mud pie mixture, topsoil makes the perfect consistency, whereas compost it doesn't. Okay, and then the other things that you will need, really simply, just a container with some water in. If you've got anything else, like old kitchen things, like you've got an old colander, a spoon, some cups and a bowl, if you've got those things, that's great. But if you don't worry, because you can just use things that you can find in your open space. So things like sticks and leaves, they're all perfect to use. If you are collecting any living things from an open space, like if you've got garden or pots outside your flat or flowers, if you want to collect some of those, make sure you're allowed to. So check with whoever looks after those flowers that you're allowed to take a couple for your Mud Kitchen. So to start with, I'm going to show you what you need to do. So it's always useful to have a bowl or bucket, or even I've got some old punnets to mix your mud and water in. So first of all, add a little bit of mud into your bowl and then add some water. And what you're trying to do is to get a consistency where your mud will, you can mould it into different shapes. Okay, so I've made mine way too watery, so I need to add some more mud. And let's keep mixing it. I'm using a muddy patch in my garden. I did check it over before I started using it, because sometimes we have cats and foxes visiting our garden, and sometimes they leave unpleasant things behind. So make sure if you are using a patch in your garden, get a grown-up just to check it over beforehand, because you don't want to find anything unpleasant whilst you're playing. Okay. I now think that's almost maybe just a little bit more water, a little bit more soil to make it perfect. There we go. Now I can take it out and I can shape it into a nice mud pie shape. I'm sticking with simple mud pies, but you might want to make pizza, a leaf sandwich, make all sorts. And you may wish to decorate your mud pie to make it a little bit more interesting. So I collected some old chive heads from our garden. And it looks like a cherry on the top. So there we go. If you have got cups and you've got lots of water, you might want to make yourself a drink to go with it. So you might choose to make hot chocolate, nice and simple. Or you might want to try adding some scented plants in. So I've got some chives and some lavender, which I'm going to add in. I've got some nice beautiful smelling lavender, which the bees absolutely love to visit in our garden. And I'm going to give that a little bit of stir. Oh yeah, that smells lovely. And there we go, I have created my mud meal. But as I said, you don't need any real equipment. You can just use things that you find, and hopefully when you get started, your imaginations will start kicking in and you'll create amazing feast. Remember though that what you are creating isn't actually for eating. Okay, so hands away. Your hands are going to get really muddy. Look at mine. I try to keep them clean, but they are filthy. So hands away from your faces whilst you're doing this activity. And grown-ups, you may wish to provide your children with a bucket of soapy water that they can wash their hands in before going inside. Okay, have fun.